Undo Send is one of my most used built-in Gmail features, and it has saved me many a time or two. But that's just one of the best Gmail tips and tricks for 2024. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and on this YouTube channel, I share a ton of Google tips and tricks just like this. As I was saying, one of the features in Gmail I use almost every single day is Undo Send. To enable Undo Send or to change the Undo Send time allotment, click on your settings gear near the top right and click on See All Settings. Under the General tab, you have an option to undo send. Here, you can enable a send cancellation period of your choosing. So you can choose between 5, 10, 20, or 30 seconds. I like 10 seconds, but with this enabled, every time you send an email, you will have a little pop-up allowing you to undo send before it actually gets sent to the recipient. Since I have 10 seconds, that's how long I have to take that email back before it goes out. Talk about super helpful if you accidentally spelt a name wrong or put the wrong information down or, heaven forbid, sent it to the wrong recipient. The next feature is actually one of my favorite time-saving tips for Gmail, and that is to use Gmail templates. I've mentioned templates a bunch of times in some other Gmail videos, which you can watch via the links in the description below, but templates are really a massive Gmail time saver. If you haven't used templates before, click on the settings gear icon and head back to all your settings. From here, head to the advanced section and make sure the templates option is enabled and click save changes. Now, every time you write an email, you can save it as a template or insert a previously saved template. So let's say you compose an email that you send all the time, like maybe a job application. You can save it as a template by selecting the three-dot menu icon by the trash can, hover over templates, save draft as template, then choose to save as a new template. Simply give your template a name to distinguish it from other templates you want to create. Now, when you go to write that same email next time, you can head back to your templates in the compose window, and this time select the template you want to insert. Of course, you can personalize this template from the compose window here, but the rest of that work is already done for you. This third Gmail tip is one that people often don't realize you can actually do in Gmail, and that is to schedule an email in Gmail. And it's as easy as you'd think. From your compose box, you'll have a drop-down menu right next to the send button. Simply click the drop-down arrow and select schedule send. You'll have a few pre-selected times, but underneath those, you'll have the option to pick a date and time. If you select that, you can customize the exact date and time you want to send the email. Then all you have to do is click schedule send and voila, you've successfully scheduled an email in Gmail. Woohoo! I go over some of these Gmail tips in more detail in my Everything Google course, which I've linked for you in the description below. In that course, you're gonna learn a ton of advanced and intermediate Gmail and Google ecosystem tips. So that's linked for you in the description below, but for now, the fourth feature I'm going to share with you is a great Gmail productivity tip, and that's to enable confidential mode and set an expiry date for an email. Yes, please. If you're sending something that's confidential and you don't want recipients to forward, copy, print, or download the email, simply click the lock icon near the bottom of your compose window to toggle on confidential mode. What I love about this mode is that you can actually set an email expiry date and even require a passcode to access the email if you wish. All you have to do is click on save, and this email is about as private as it gets. All right, did you know you can change your Gmail label icons to be text instead? Well, you can. Here's what I mean. So by default, you may have these icons at the top when you're in an email. Some users may find the icons hard to understand. So if we head back to our trusty Gmail settings, this time let's scroll down to the button labels section. We can actually toggle on the text option instead. So now back inside Gmail, we've got text labels at the top rather than icons, a helpful little known Gmail setting indeed, especially if you're unfamiliar with what the icons mean. Something else I do all the time in Gmail is to snooze emails until it's at a time that's convenient for me. So let's say you get an email that you don't need to deal with right now, but you want to deal with it later, but you also don't want to forget about it later. Well, let Gmail do the reminder work for you. If you hover over the email in your inbox and click on the little clock icon that appears, you'll have the option to pick a time to snooze the email until. There are defaults set, but you can also pick a custom date and time. Meaning, if you pick, say, later this week, this email will pop back up to the top of your inbox later that week at that date and time when you need it. I find this acts like a really good reminder for upcoming tasks that I have to do. And if you made a mistake and you're like, oh no, where did that email go? No worries, you can actually access it and get it back before it's popped back up into your inbox. Just take a little gander right here at the left side of your inbox. You may notice a snoozed option. Simply click that option and voila, here we go. We've got our snoozed emails right here. Plus, you'll even be able to see on the right-hand side of the email list the times and dates the emails are scheduled to come back into your inbox. And you can reply to any of these just by clicking on the email, or of course, you could unsnooze the email right from here too by clicking unsnooze. And before I share what I think is tip number 7, if I can count properly, if you're finding this video helpful so far, remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. So Gmail tip number 7 is going to focus on a little known search feature. You can use the asterisk to search for a contact even if you can't remember their name. Yeah, no name, no problem. I use the search bar in Gmail multiple times a day for a myriad of different reasons. It is so easy to search for email subjects or senders or sent emails, but you can go a lot deeper. So in your search bar at the top, let's say you don't know the name of the person, but you remember the company and the domain. You can put an asterisk in place of their name followed by their company domain. Hit enter, and Gmail has pulled up all the emails from that company email. The asterisk in this case literally means anything. So Gmail is searching anything at that domain. So now you can easily find the person who you had to follow up with. So those are just a few of the best Gmail tips and tricks. Remember, I have a ton of other Gmail videos that go over probably anything you could think of and more, and I have a lot of those listed for you in the description below. So now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Gmail tips and tricks and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gmail content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.